कोई जगह सेंट्रल लड़की। नमस्कार, माय नेम इज नीलकंठन। आई विल बी डूइंग द प्रवचनम टुडे फॉर द नेक्स्ट वन आवर ऑन हिंदुइज्म और सनातन धर्म। I'm going to start today with a different kind of stotra on Paramatma. Paramatma is whole and complete. Now, what I mean by this is, he created this whole universe that is part of his whole body. However, what happens? That means what people will think when the universe is there as a separate entity, then there will be a portion of his wholesome missing from his whole body. Not so. That's what I'm going to explain. Suppose you take a pizza pie. It has got 8 slices, and you eat 2 slices. So what the pie has got 6 more slices, right? That is normally the case. This does not fit Paramatma, because Paramatma, even though the universe came out of him, he is still whole. So the one that example that will fit Paramatma is, if you have a lighted candle, one that is lighted and another one that is not lighted, and then I'm going to take the one that is not lighted, go to the lighted candle, take the flame from there, and then light the second one. What happens? The two candles are now lighted. But the earlier first candle still remains exactly the same as it was before the lighting was done for the second candle. That is exactly what is Paramatma. He remains wholesome. And the sloka for this is found for the Shanti Mantra Sloka for Ishavashya Upanishad, that is belonging to Shukla Yajurveda. Now I am going to chant that sloka. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Dashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Okay. Today's subject is understanding our Hinduism. We need to understand our Hinduism. It is also called Sanatana Dharma. Okay, let me make some quick initial speech. I thank Sri Paresh Joshi for asking me to give the pravachanam before you all. Now, compared to our respected priest Brijesh Ji and Vishnu Ji, my spiritual knowledge is very minuscule, very small. I will share with you whatever little I know. For today's pravachan, I will talk about the topic briefly on certain items, certain topics, and read from the script for certain other topics. Usually I end up reading towards the end because I am due to lack of time. I hope I don't have that problem today. As I have said before, all of you devotees are younger than me, so I consider you all as my children. Kindly practice those karmas that I am going to be talking about today that appeal to you. And you don't have to necessarily practice all the karmas. You verify from your own knowledgeable person source And then if they approve of those karmas, then you practice that in your everyday life. We are humans and make mistakes every day. And we have to correct our mistakes on an ongoing basis by replacing our bad vasanas of the past with good vasanas. Now, this is the only way our personality will change. For some people, this change in personality may even take several lives. Only after consistent practice over and over again, these new vasanas will sink into the mind and eventually become like a second nature, and we will perform these new karmas without thought. Let me emphasize this again. Practice, practice, practice. This is the secret formula of spirituality. Now, practicing simply is not good enough. We have to do practice with faith. Now, my Sanskrit knowledge is not as good, so bear with me. I will stumble in certain cases. As of today, I have done 3 more pravachans in the past, and you will see quite a lot of repetitions. And I am doing these repetitions only because those karmas that I have talked in the past, they are so important. I want you to just please be aware of it over and over again, and just be aware of them in order for you to practice in your life. Now, now let us go to the initial prayers for today. We always start our prayer to first with Lord Ganesha. Om Sri Maha Ganapataye Namaha. Matru Devo Bhava. Pitru Devo Bhava. Acharya Devo Bhava. Atiti Devo Bhava. Satyam Vada. Dharmam Chara. Om Bhadram Karne Vishraniyama Devaha. Bhadram Pashye Machabir Yajatraha. Tirai Rangai Pagam Satyanu Bhihi. Yashema Devahitam Yadayaha. Vatyanayandro Vridrachravaha. Vatyana Pusha Vishwa Vedaha. Swati Nastacharyo Arishtane Mihi. Swati No Brihat Padir Dadato. Om Shanti 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 Ji. Now, we will start with our today's subject, understanding our Hinduism or Sanatana Dharma. This subject today, it is essentially the condensed format of the book that I have published in the year 2016. It has got like 400 pages. What I have covered, 400 pages, is like an ocean. But what I want to do is, in 1 hour, I'm going to condense that ocean into a river. That means I am going to try to condense the entire subject today in a short period of 1 hour. It is impossible for me to cover all my 400 pages of the book in one hour, but I'm going to try my best to provide you a summary of the entire book in 1 hour. The book that I wrote was essentials of Hinduism, a practice guide. That this is the book that I had written, and this book is available for purchase. And I just want to cover this entire book in possibly 1 hour. The first thing that I want to start is, I have got 4 charts in front of me. I'm going to cover these 4 charts as short as possible. This is chart number 1. I don't know whether you just please listen to me, because I don't think you will be able to see the chart so good even if I show it to you. I will just talk about it, and you, Vishnu sir, sorry, excuse me, Vishnu sir, I want to show you something. Please pardon me for a couple of seconds. Is there any way we can block this? Because block artillery.
இது ஒண்ணும் இல்ல, அது ஆல்ரெடி எல்லாம் நல்லா போயிட்டு இருக்கு.
இது block artillery, இது இந்த வலம் மாதிரி தெரியுது உடம்பு.
இல்ல இல்ல, அது உள்ளுக்குள்ள கரெக்டா இருக்கு.
சரியா இருக்கு.
சரியா இருக்கு, சரியா இருக்கு.
அது ஒண்ணு, அது ஒண்ணு இல்ல, வராது இல்ல,
ஒண்ணு வர.
ஓகே, குட். சாரி. ஓகே, chart number 1 is the creation of the universe. பரமாத்மா. Who is பரமாத்மா? பரமாத்மா is Vasudeva Krishna. This is what we talked about in my very first Parvachanam that I did in September. Now, Paramatma represents Satya and Dharma. Vasudeva takes 3 forms, Vishnu, Brahma, and Shiva. Okay, now Vishnu guided Brahma, and Brahma created the universe. How did he do it? He used the Panchabhuta, Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Appu, and Prithvi, and created the universe. And then he created after that the jivatmas with different kinds of species. What are they? The devas, the humans or the manushyas, the animals, the birds, the crawlers, the amphibians, and the plants. All these are the things that he created using the panchabhutas. So much for chart 1. Now I will go to chart 2. Chart 2 is the Sanatana Dharma or Hinduism doctrines. It has 2 parts. One is the part that we are practicing. The other part is the knowledge or scriptures. So these are the 2 parts explained in detail. But these 2 items are explained in detail in the next chart. This is chart 2, that is small one. Chart 3 Sanatana Dharma, which is practice, and the scriptures denoting the knowledge. Now it has got the practice. What you have got? Practice, you have got 2 types. Both are mandatory. One is called the Nitya Karma, and another is called the Naimittika Karma. Nitya Karma means the karmas that we have to practice every day. And what are these? These are the karmas to be done. Particularly the Brahmins, they have to perform Sandhya Vandanas 3 times in a day, morning, afternoon, and evening. Then Gayatri Japas, Brahmagya, Snana and Agamarshana Sutta, Upasana, Devata Pujana, Vaitvadeva, and Atithi Puja, Pujana. Now, there are some karmas that are done occasionally, not every day, occasionally. What are they? They are coming under 40 samskaras. And then I am just going to cover these 40 samskaras in another heading later. Then we have Ashtottaras and Trishatis, Lakshachanas, Sahasranamas, and another a long elaborate prayer for Lord Shiva, which is called Mahanyasa. Then there are the third one, again, occasional Naimittika Karma. It is called Aparakarma. What are Aparakarmas? Aparakarmas are the deeds done for the dead ancestors. Tarpanas and Shuddha, Shraddha. Again, I have covered this in another heading, little bit more in detail later. All these I am giving, it's only just like a brief introduction of all the different karmas. These will be covered later, item by item. Some in detail, some quickly. And then there are the fourth kind of karmas called Kamya karmas, Dhanas, and Nishiddha karmas. So much for practice of the karmas. Then comes the scriptures, knowledge. Three, four items, very important. Shastras, Shruti, Puranas, Itihasas, and one more item I will say here also, most important, is Shruti. Okay? Shruti is covered in complete details and it covers the Vedas. Shruti means that which is heard. That I will cover later. Then on Shastras, we have got Vedavashyas, Darsanas, Arthasastra, Vastu Sastra, Agama Sastra, Tarka Sastra, Mimamsa. Smritis, there are 18 Smritis. Puranas, 18 Puranas. Itihasas, 3 Itihasas. So much for scriptures. Finally, I am going in more details on the Hinduism chart. This is the most descriptive chart that I have in my possession. Even if I show you, you are not going to be able to read it. Sorry for that. But I will just quickly talk about them. This is like a overview, I would say. Later on, I will go to the details. Okay, scriptures, like I said before, Srutis, Smritis, Itihasas, Puranas, and I've covered another item here that I did not say before, Prabandhas. Vedas, item number one, are four in number, Rig Veda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Atharvana Veda. Now, in all these cases, I'm not going to tell the same thing over and over again. It's a repetition. Each item has got Samhitas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas, and Upanishads. All these four Vedas have got that. There is only one exception for Yajurveda. Yajurveda has got two parts. One is called Krishna Yajurveda and another is called Shukla Yajurveda. Now, Shukla Yajurveda is mostly practiced in northern India. Then comes Upavedas. Upavedas are a smaller item that I will cover later. Then our third item is Vedangas. Vedangas has got Siksha, Vyakarana, Vyakarana means grammar, and then Jyotisha, astrology, Kalpa, Nirukta. Next item, most important Vedanta. And the last item is Upanishads. There are 108 Upanishads, of which 10 Upanishads are considered as principal Upanishads, and there are remaining another 98 Upanishads. Then comes Smriti. You got Manusmriti, Vyasa Smriti, and several other Smritis that I'm not going to go into detail because there are too many. Brahma Sutra is also covered under this Smriti also. Itihasas. Under Itihasas, you have got Ramayana and Mahabharata. But I have added one more because Mahabharata has got another important section called Bhagavad Gita that I have also included under Itihasa. Then Puranas, there are 18 Mula Puranas, including Srimad Bhagavatam. And there is one item that I did not tell in my other chart. It's called Prabandha. It is Divya Prabandha. So much for the chart. Now, what I am going to do now is I am going to go to the subject matter of today, understanding of our Hinduism or Sanatana Dharma in a detailed fashion. Not necessarily for every item, but wherever I feel it is needed to cover more in detail, I will do so. Before I do that, I am just left out one item that I want to stress is the, like I always do, lessons learned. Lessons learned that I want to emphasize for the first four items, like chart one, chart two, chart three, chart four. I would just read this one for you. Maya. This worldly life appears to us as real. This was the title for my third pravachan. We will recognize the same world as unreal only when we attain Brahman, the truth. How do we do this? By detachment from the worldly objects that are transient and substitute with attachment to the Supreme Brahman who is permanent. Okay, now comes the Roman letter 2. First one, Roman letter 1 was charts. Number 2 is in-depth studies for understanding of our Hinduism or Sanatana Dharma. The creation of universe. Paramatma Vasudeva, he is the Satya, absolute truth. In the beginning, Paramatma Vasudeva existed alone and it was all total darkness. Nothing else living existed. Paramatma desired creations. So he performed penance, deep thoughts. And after having performed penance, Vishnu appeared. Then Vishnu created Brahma. And finally, Brahma created Shiva. And all these three, Vishnu, Brahma, and Shiva, are together known as the Trimurtis. Now, Brahma's creations. Now, let us focus on the Brahma's creations in accordance with the Vishnu's guidance. The creations were started using the natural elements of Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Appu, and Prithvi in that order. Akasha is what? Space. Vayu is air. Agni is fire. Appu is water. And Prithvi is the earth. These five elements were together known as the Pancha Bhutas. The universe was formed using the Pancha Bhutas. Next subject. What is Satya? Meaning of Satya is, everybody knows Satya means truth. But whatever that does not change is the truth. whatever is permanent is the truth. Only Brahman or Paramatma is Satya. If you take anything relating to humans, what happens? Change happens every day with our body. 5 years before we were younger, but now we are looking older. 5 years later we will be older again, much more. Child is growing from age 1 to age 10 to age 20, like that. So this change happens. That means humans are not Satya. What is Sanatana Dharma? That is the topic of today. Hinduism used to be known as Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma has no beginning, has no end, and is indestructible. The famous Hindu Dharma truth is Dharmo Rakshati Rakshitaha. It is very important. It's a sloka. I suggest everybody memorize this. And the meaning of this is, if you preserve the Dharma will protect you. Next, Sandhya Vandana and Gayatri Japa. These two items are very important for the Brahmins. Sandhya Vandanas are daily prayers offered by a Hindu Brahmin to the sun god. Essentially, there are three rituals: pranayama, that is explained later, argya pradana, pouring water with mantras, Gayatri Japa. In addition, there are also other elaborate mantras to the sun god. The Sandhya Vandanas are done in the early morning before sunrise, during mid-moon time, and then one in the evening before sunset. Now remember, all Brahmins should know this truth. This is very important for all the Brahmins to know this truth. If we perform Sandhya Vandanas every day, we do not get punyas. However, if we do not perform Sandhya Vandanas every day, we will accumulate papas every day. So Sandhya Vandana is an essential Nitya Karma for all Brahmins. I request every Brahmin person to realize that it is important for them to perform the Sandhya Vandana Nitya Karma. Devata Pujana and daily prayers. Okay. Here, essentially, this is spirituality. I am going to read out, chant one very, very important sloka for all Hindus. Nine is a spiritual number. So at least preferably once a week, I would prefer that you read this, you chant this Veda mantra. I will tell it very slowly, and I will also give you the reference where this is found. Brahma Jnana Prakasha Mantra. To arrive at Brahma Jnana, this mantra will help a lot. Practice this. अरे अहम वृक्षरेव कीर्ति पृष्ठम गिरेव ऊर्ध पवित्रो वाजिनी स्मृतमस्मी द्रविणगम सर्वचसम सुमेधामृतोचित त्रिश्रृंगोर्वेदानुवचनम I will repeat it one more time for your benefit, because this mantra is so important for everyone to practice in their life at least once a week. It is called Brahma Jnana Prakasha Mantra It is found in the Taittiriya Upanishad, Sikshavalli, 8th Anuvaka Sloka. Agam Vrityatya Reriva, Ketihi Prittam Gireriva, Udba Pavitro Vajiniva, Swamritam Asmi, Ravinagam, Sabbachasam, Sumedamrito Chitaka, Iti Tritrangor Vedanu Vachanam. Okay, next in the Devata Pujana, chanting Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra and Veda Mantras properly with total Shraddha, Bhakti, etc. Now, there are 10 recommendations that I am going to let you know now, for you to practice when you do the prayers every day. When you do prayers, when you do chant mantras, whatever you do, please practice these following. One is, in fact, I would say, before you start these prayers, talk to Paramatma as follows. Tell him to provide you Shraddha, dedication, bhakti, devotion, jnana, knowledge, vairagya, willpower, manasuddhi, mind cleanliness, buddhi suddhi, intellect cleanliness, vag suddhi, clarity of speech, akshara suddhi, clarity in pronunciation of speech or mantras or prayers. Karma Suddhi, action cleanliness all day, and most importantly, Arogya Suddhi, keeping body in good health at all times. Because any amount of wealth that you may have will never compensate for good health. Now, learning all these things is definitely important, but it is very, very important that you practice what you have learned regularly and consistently all life. Do not miss your prayers unless you are seriously sick. The karmas to learn and practice every day in our entire life are the following. Number one, Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra. I think talked about this in each of my three other pravachanams, and I am repeating again because it is so important that we chant Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra every day. And I have stated before, Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra will take like 20 minutes to half an hour if you chant it in medium pace speed. But it will take 1 to 2 years to learn it properly. But until you learn this, you can simultaneously start practicing from right now onwards the small sloka on Sri Rama. Sri Rama Rama Rameti Rame Rame Mano Rame Sagastranama Tattvalyam Ramanama Varanane. This sloka actually says, you are repeating the name of Rama. In other words, Rama being the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. So you are repeating Vishnu's name 1,000 times, just by this short sloka. But you should do this sloka chanting only until you learn the full Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra. You can also, in case you are very, very sick on those days, you can simply chant Sri Rama Rama Rameti Sloka that I just told you. Now, the next item is Veda Mantras. It's my favorite. I absolutely urge everybody, apart from Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra, everybody should practice chanting Veda Mantras. Now, Veda is a portion. We got 4 Vedas. Rig Veda. I'm coming to that later. But you cannot do Veda chanting in detail. So you have to pick something of your favorite that you can learn. And I have chosen to do Sri Rudra Prashnaha every day. Rudra is really a combination of Lord Shiva's mantra and Lord Shiva. The first part is Rudra Prashnaha and the next part is Chamaka. So these two are together. In addition, there is also a third part which is chanted very often, which is called Purusha Sukta. So the three are set, Rudra, Chamaka and Purusha Sukta. Everybody has to learn this. However, that doesn't mean you should not learn some other Veda mantra. You can pick anything else. Now, in my earlier pravachanams, I took a anuvaka of Rudra and chanted for you to give a sample of the Veda mantra, how difficult it is. Today, I am going to chant one anuvaka of a different Veda mantra. I have picked today to chant Narayana Upanishad, one anuvaka on Sriman Narayana. It's my favorite too. I chant it periodically. Here it is. Please listen carefully. It's beautiful to hear this. Atha Nityo Narayanaka, Brahma Narayanaka, Shivascha Narayanaka, Shakrascha Narayanaka, Dhyava Prithivyauccha Narayanaka, Kalascha Narayanaka, Vishascha Narayanaka, Urvascha Narayanaka, Adascha Narayanaka, Antarbhagischa Narayanaka, Narayana Yevedagum Sarvam, Yadbhutam Yachabhavyam, Nishkalo Niranjano Nirvikalpo Nirakyataka, Chuddho Deva Eko Narayanaka, Nadvitiyo Atti Kashchite, Ya Evam Veda, Sa Vishnureva Bhavati, Sa Vishnureva Bhavati. Isn't it beautiful? I will urge this everybody to also learn this if possible. This is another recommendation for you. Again, please remember, Vishnu Sahasranama and Veda Mantra are two essential practices for progressing in spirituality. Consistent practice is very important. Atithi Pujana. Atithi Devo Bhava. Atithi means surprise guest. Somebody who just walks in. You have to treat him with respect. He is almost like God. You have to treat him with respect. Give him water. Offer him a seat with kindness. Give him food. And make him happy. Atithi should be treated as Deva with utmost respect. Next item is 40 samskaras. Hinduism has got 40 samskaras. That samskaras means what? Like rituals. Rituals that you follow in your life from the time of your birth until the time of your death. There are 40 samskaras recommended for Hindus to practice in life. Now, I do not have the time to run through all these 40 samskaras. All I will do for you is, I will name a few that are important. Number one, Anna Prashna. Feeding the baby with cooked rice for the first time. Next is Upanayana, threat ceremony. Next is Vivaha, marriage ceremony. Next is Simanta, rituals performed in the 7th month after pregnancy to the would-be mother for safe delivery of the baby. Okay, next item, Aparakarmas. Aparakarmas are rituals done after the death of an individual. Known as Antyeshti or funeral. One other important aprakarma is the rituals done on a periodical basis known as the Shraddha for the parents as or as applicable people. If you know parents are alive, then you don't have to perform for them. It's only for dead people and for other ancestors in the Pitruloka. Next is Kamya Karma. Kamya Karmas are rituals done occasionally. One example, if we desire a long life, we can perform Ayushya Oma. Nishiddha Karmas. What are Nishiddha Karmas? Nishiddha Karmas are bad karmas that we should avoid completely throughout our life. Our sastras instruct that Nishiddha Karmas are sinful. Some examples for Nishiddha Karmas: telling lies, stealing, greediness, anger, all these are all Nishiddha Karmas that we have to avoid in life. Sastras, I have identified here 6 sastras. I am just going to read through this because of shortage of time. It is already 6:40, so I am going to have to run fast. Number 1, Mimamsa Sastra. It does inquiries, research, and gives the essential details of the Vedas. I will describe Vedas later. Darshanas. Darshanas are visions of truth. Truth is first known by listening to the declaration in the Vedas. This is Shravana. Then it is stabilized in one's mind by thinking over and over again by reasoning. This is Manana. These systems of thought are darshanas. Agama and Tarka. Agama, referred as Agama Sastra, known as Tantras, is a religious system capable of helping man at the basic level of spiritual growth. Tarka is a system of logic elaborating the principles of debate, or Tarka. Veda Bhashya. Now, what is Bhashya? Bhashya means meaning. So Veda Bhashya, meaning of the Vedas. Without even knowing the meaning of the Vedas, if we recite the Veda mantras properly, the mantra shakti of the sounds will protect the person and who recites as well as the one who listens, as long as this is done with faith. However, it is recommended to know the meanings of the Veda mantras from the Veda Bhashya. Bhashya means meaning. Vastu Sastra. Vastu Sastra helps us to determine how to build a town, a house, a facility, the best way to do the things relating to the spiritual task, etc. Vastu Sastra even specifies where to place the idols of God, which direction a house should face, etc. Artha Sastra. As for Hinduism, Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha are the 4 Purusharthas, or purposes of human life. Artha comes after Dharma. What is Artha? Artha means the things needed to survive in our everyday life. Bhajagovindam, verse 29. Artham anartham bhavaya nityam. Command from the master to the disciple seeking liberation. Please reflect on artham and anartham. Think about what they truly are. There won't be even a particle of sukha at the end from both. This is satya. Dhanas. What are dhanas? Dhanas means charity. There are various kinds of dhanas. Vastru dana, vastra dana, vidya dana, annadana, etc. There are even several other dhanas that I am not having time to list all of them. But of all these dhanas, the most important is the annadana, and that too feeding a hungry person has no match, no value. It's an unbelievable value for that. It's recommended we do annadana as and when opportunity comes in our life. Next important topic is Shruti. What is Shruti? Shruti, it's called Shruti. Paramatma's breathings were heard and interpreted by our Maharishis that came to be known as the Vedas. Now, due to shortage of time, I am going to go real fast. I am going to read through my script. The Vedas are the sacred ancient texts of India. The word Veda literally means knowledge. Principal scriptures of Hinduism. Vedas are the principal scriptures of the Hinduism. And they have got two parts called Samhita and the Brahmanas. Samhita consists of the mantras and Brahmanas interpret the meaning of the mantras. Now, when are the Vedas born? It is like 4000 BC to 1000 BC in this range. That is working out to approximately 6000 plus years from today. 6000 years back, Vedas came into existence. The Vedas are packed with mantras. They point only towards one direction. What is that? Paramatma. You can learn everything about Paramatma from the Vedas. Mahavakya are the popular, powerful statement. Each Veda has got a Mahavakya. There are four Vedas. The Rig Veda, the Yajur Veda, the Sama Veda, and the Atharvana Veda. Now, Rig Veda identifies with the path of jnana or knowledge for the path of moksha. The Karma Kanda has subparts of Samhita, Brahmanas, and Aranyakas. Now, Agni is the predominant deva of the Rig Veda. Purusha Sukta, Sri Sukta, Agni Sukta and Pavamana Sukta are the prominent suktas of the Rig Veda. What is the Mahavakya of the Rig Veda? Prajnanam Brahma. Consciousness is Brahman. Next is Yajur Veda. Yajur Veda identifies with the path of karma or action for the path of moksha. Now, Pavamana Sukta, Agamarshana Sutta are some examples of the Yajur Veda. There are Yajur Veda has got two branches. One is called Shukla Yajur Veda, another is the Krishna Yajur Veda. The mantra chantings are different in both these kinds of Vedas. The Mahavakya of the Yajur Veda is Aham Brahmasmi. I am Brahman. Next is Samaveda. Samaveda means sweet songs or hymns. Samaveda Mahavakya is Tattvam Asi. Thou art that. You are Brahman. Atharvana Veda. The Atharvana Veda, it removes the ignorance. That is the darkness. It is removed by Atharvana Veda, that is the fire. The greatness of prana and the protection of prana as well as the prolongation of life are some of the things that you can learn from Atharvana Veda. The Atharvana Veda Mahavakya is I am Atma Brahma. This self is Brahman. Now, the next few items I will run through fast. Upavedas. There are four Upavedas: Ayurveda, Dhanurveda, Gandharva Veda, and Arthasastra. Vedangas. Vedangas can be split as Veda plus Anga. Vedangas are six: Siksha, Vyakarana, Nirukta, Chanda, Jyotisha, and Kalpa. Vedanta. What are Vedantas? Vedantas occurs at the end of the Vedas. Very important. You want to know this? Vedanta is the philosophical part of the Vedas. Vedanta is not an easy subject to comprehend. In order to understand Vedas, Vedanta, a person has to practice total detachment from the worldly affairs, deep bhakti, and total devotion to the Almighty Paramatma. Upanishads. Upanishads provide intimate teachings for enlightenment. Now, there are 108 Upanishads, of which there are 10 principal Upanishads. I wish I can go through in detail for all these Upanishads, but I have got very short time left. Next is Smritis. Smriti word means law book or a manual of code of conduct for the Hindus. And the most important, prominent Smriti is the Manusmriti. Next is, when you compare Smriti and Shruti, definitely Shruti or the Vedas will be the primary scriptures of Hinduism. Next is Brahma Sutras. Brahma Sutras are aphorisms, meaning short sayings stating great truths. All great acharyas agreed that Brahman is the cause of the creation of the universe, and so the knowledge of him leads to final liberation, which is the goal to be attained by everyone in this world. Also, the Brahman can be known only through the scriptures and not through mere reasonings. However, there were differences as to the nature of the Brahman. According to Adi Shankara, Brahman is without attributes, Nirguna Brahman. According to Ramanuja, Brahman as form, Saguna Brahman. According to Shruti and Smriti, Brahman is pure intelligence and he is attributeless. It goes on and on with philosophical discussions. Brahma Sutra consists of various sutras and were intended as discussions on various spiritual topics. Itihasas. Itihasas contains epics. The two principal itihasas are Srimad Ramayana and Mahabharata. Now, Ramayana. In the epic of Srimad Ramayana, it happened in the Treta Yuga. Throughout Ramayana, Sri Rama teaches us how to practice Dharma. Lord Mahavishnu incarnated as Rama as a human to fight and kill the demon king Ravana and stop his misdeeds, to free his wife Sita from Ravana's captivity, to acquire the great friendship with Sri Hanuman, as well as practice and teach Dharma throughout his life. Mahabharata. The epic of Mahabharata happened in the Dwapara Yuga. Lord Krishna is the highlight of the Mahabharata. The first highlight of Mahabharata is the appearance of the Bhagavad Gita. The second highlight of the Mahabharata is the emergence of the powerful Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra. Actually, I have also included Bhagavad Gita under the Itihasas, because Bhagavad Gita is part of the Mahabharata. And there are 18 chapters and 701 slokas in Bhagavad Gita. I strongly urge everybody to learn and understand Bhagavad Gita in your life. And I have selected two important slokas of Bhagavad Gita to give a sampling. One of them is chapter 4, sloka 24. Brahmarpanam brahmahivir brahmagno brahmanahutam brahmaivatena gantavya brahmakarma samadhina. Brahman is everything. Brahman shall certainly be reached by whom? By him who sees Brahman in all his actions. The famous sloka is chanted throughout India as a prayer at the dinner table before the Hindus eat their meals. It is recommended to practice this karma in our everyday life before we eat our meals as a method to thank Paramatma for providing us the foods for our survival. The next sloka is chapter 9, sloka number 26. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yo me bhaktya prayachati tadagam bhaktyu pakrtapnami prayatat manah. Okay, whomever, meaning is this, whomever offers Paramatma with devotion a leaf, a flower, a fruit, water, that I accept offered by the pure minded with devotion, Paramatma will accept from us a single flower or fruit whenever it is offered to him with true devotion. Therefore, it is very important for us to practice Shraddha or dedication and bhakti or devotion during our prayers. I sincerely believe there is one person in my immediate family who practices this way of prayers and qualifies to obtain the grace of Paramatma for sure. Puranas. Puranas will be classified into 18 Mula Puranas and 17 Upa Puranas. The important Puranas, some of them are Srimad Bhagavata, Vishnu Purana, Brahma Purana, Shiva Purana, Skanda Purana. Some Upa Puranas are Narayaniya, Nandi and Vasishta Puranas. Srimad Bhagavata. Srimad Bhagavata contains the essence of all the Vedas and Upanishads. Bhagavata should be read, heard in 7 days, just as Sage Shuka narrated the Bhagavata Katha in 7 days to King Parikshit, who attained moksha after his death. The ultimate purpose of our life on this Bhuloka. Brahma Jnana through Om Dhyana. A very important karma to be practiced during our life is the practice of Om Dhyana every day. Next, moksha. Brahma Jnana will give you the moksha, or no more birth after death. The Jivatma will merge with Paramatma. Okay, now that completes the book items, but I have got few other things that I have identified that is related to Hinduism. I am going to go through that now. Number one, accept your sins and surrender to Paramatma every day. Admit your sins. Talk to him. Admit your sins committed knowingly and unknowingly in this life, in the past life. Beg him, or even cry if necessary, if you feel that is necessary. Ask him to help. Help you not to commit sins from now onwards. Totally surrender yourself to Paramatma every day. This process is known as Saranagati. Aham Brahmasmi. Now, having faith in our Jivatma as Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahman, on a continuous basis all our life, and removing our vasanas completely will make us God someday for sure. Everyday purification of our Jivatma. Okay. We brush our teeth every day. We take our bath every day. What are we doing these for? To clean our body. The same way, we have to clean our Jivatma every day. How do we do that? We practice. One of the things I will recommend is Kamokarchit Japa. Kamokarchit, Manyurakarchit, Namona Maka. Kamokarchit, Manyurakarchit, Namona Maka. You chant this. This will remove your kama and krodha. Then you have to replace all our bad vasanas with good vasanas. You have to remove your arishad bargas. You have to remove your other bad vasanas. So many, like complaining, there are multiple things I can say about other vasanas, you know. Anyway, what I would recommend is, it is very important that we practice these removal of bad vasanas and replacement with good vasanas all your life. Next item, very, very important, Guru. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwaraha, Guru Satchat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri, Gurave Namaha. Guru is Brahma, Guru is Vishnu, Guru is Maheshwara, Guru is the self-revealing, limitless Brahman. Salutations to that revered Guru. Guru means darkness. Guru means removal. What are you removing? The Guru is the person who removes your darkness of ignorance and gives you knowledge. Now, if you sincerely want Guru in your life, God will provide you a Guru. It happened in my case. My Guru is Sri 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 Bharati Teetha Mahaswamigal, and he resides in Sringeri in Karnataka, about 200 miles from Bangalore, from Mangalore. And you will definitely, I promise, you will learn how to live spiritual life in the proper manner from this Guru. Life extension. I recommend for life extension the practice of pranayama, the practice of Ayushya Sukta. Life is fragile, like a glass. Be careful. We have to protect our life by living carefully and focusing our karmas on removing our arshad vargas and other vasanas. Mahapapa. Shiva and Vishnu Veda is Mahapapa. We should not differentiate. We should not say one is superior to the other. So I will recommend during the daytime, you can chant Om Namo Narayanaya. Keep on chanting. Instead of thinking all useless thoughts sometimes comes and bothers you. Instead of doing all those thoughts, chant Om Namo Narayanaya. Make this as your practice. In the evening, chant Om Namah Shivaya. Mauna or silence. Maintain mauna or silence for some time in the evening every day. That is another very good practice, good vasanas to practice to replace the bad vasana. Now, listen to this. Next birth may or may not be human birth. Based on the karmas we do in our life, the next birth may not be a human birth. So, we have to be careful how we live our life. Om Dhyana for half an hour is recommended every day. Read Panchanga. Panchanga is the five limbs of the day. What are they? Tithi, Vara, Nakshatra, Yoga, and Karana. Review of the Tithi, 15 Tithis in the fortnight, gives you wealth. Vara or day gives you life extension. Nakshatra gives you rid of the sins. Yoga gets rid of the sickness. Karana gives you to accomplish planned tasks. Pranayama. Our body continues to inhale and exhale the breath from birth to death and stays alive only due to prana. I recommend we adopt the 1:2:4 ratio. Now, what is 1:4? Inhale the breath, for example, through the left nostril, like that, for 5 seconds. Now, control the breath for 10 seconds. Close to both the nostrils. Then exhale the breath for 20 seconds. Now, 5, 10, 20. This is just an example. You can do different ratio, different time. And then you reverse this process. This is the pranayama. By doing this, you are controlling the, you are increasing the breath cycle, breathing cycle, and that will prolong your life. Renunciation. Na karmana na prajaya na tyage naike amritatvamana shahu. Adi Shankara has emphasized, neither by work, nor by progeny, by bringing forth children, nor by riches, but by renunciation alone, one can attain immortality or moksha. Okay, next is very important. Satsangam. Satsangs. Adi Shankara has told this very famous sloka. Satsangatve nitsangatvam, nitsangatve nirmohatvam, nirmohatve nitsalatvam, nitsalatatve jivan muktihi. This sloka emphasizes that we have spiritual discussions with spiritual people on a regular basis that will help you to clean your bad vasana. Take care of your dharma patni. Give your wife the respect she deserves because she is the Mahalakshmi of your family. Family with dignity for wife is a happy family. The wife should also take care of husband's needs throughout the married life. Tarpanas and Shraddhas for the departed souls. Monthly Tarpanas are Amavasya. In fact, I had to perform Amavasya Tarpana today for my parents. Today is Amavasya Day. Annual Shraddha is performed once every year, one for the father, one for the mother. Special Mahalaya Paksha Tarpana is performed for 15 days, and this year it happened from 9/21/21 to 10/5/21. The three important studies I recommend are Srimad Narayana, the Bhagavad Gita, and the Bhagavatam. For Narayana, I have just quoted a sloka here. Vedavedye pare pumsi jate dasharadatmaje veda pacheta sada sita sakshat ramayanatmana. Now, for Bhagavad Gita, I have chanted this sloka even before. Chapter 2, sloka 47. Karmanye vadikaratte ma phaletum kadachana ma karma phala etur bhumat. Te sango sa karma vakarmani. What does it say? You have got the right only to do your karma. Don't worry about the results. God will take care of it. And then Srimad Bhagavatam, again, you have got one very popular sloka. Nigama kalpa sarod palitam palam sukha mukhat mritat tat samyuktam vipata bhagavata rasamalayam muhuraho rachika ubi bhavukaha. I strongly recommend everybody learn Bhagavata someday in your life. The final request to the temple devotees, I have got four recommendations, important lessons that I want you to carry with you. One is, this human life is too precious to waste. The second is, don't be concerned about your image and what others will think of you. You do your karma every day as best as you can, and replacing the bad vasanas with good vasanas. Third is, seeking Brahmajnana should be the highest purpose of our life. Brahmavid Brahmaiva Bhavati. The knower of Brahman becomes Brahman. And finally, Lord Krishna's assurance to all of us. Lord Krishna has given the final following assurance to all of us. He is asking us to completely surrender to him, and he will forgive our sins and take care of us. And the most important sloka is chapter 18, sloka 66. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam charanam vraja. Agam pa sarva papebhyo mochayishyami machuchaha. Abandoning all dharmas of your body, mind and intellect, take refuge in me alone. I will liberate you from all sins, greed, not. Okay. Finally, we have concluded our pravachan today. As done in the past, we have to chant our last concluding sloka. Kayena vacha manasa indriyairva buddhyatmanava hrudaye svabhava karomi yad yad sakalam parasmai srimannarayanayeti samarpayami. Thank you so much, all the devotees. I have published two books that I want to just let you know. One is The Essentials of Hinduism, a practice guide, and the other one is The Find God Inside You. These two books are available for purchase from me. My name is Neelakantan, and telephone number is 702-838-7174. Thank you so much, all devotees. God bless you all.